this in the light. And to be honest with you, no one's had anything to compare to say, well, you know, the Broncos are good, bad, in between. Nobody knows because we haven't seen the other competition. Looks like the test is underway.
So they maintain possession. The ball spotted exactly at the 40. Jens Nielsen, the quarterback. Backs are in the eye. Slavin's in Tate. Hand off to Jason Tate over the left side. He'll get 4 yards on the carry.
That, tell you, that play, I knew what that was coming out of the locker room. Coach Swenson decided on that play a long time ago. Jason, the Broncos are good, bad, in between. Nobody knows because we haven't seen the other competition. Looks like the test is underway.
So they maintain possession. The ball spotted exactly at the 40. Jens Nielsen, the quarterback. Backs are in the eye. Slavin's in Tate. Hand off to Jason Tate over the left side. He'll get 4 yards on the carry.
That, tell you, that play, I knew what that was coming out of the locker room. Coach Swenson decided on that play a long time ago. Jason took that handoff. That was an option. The fullback, if he felt like he had a hole, could take the handoff. Or Jens Nielsen could go around the end. He had a lot of room going around the end. But Jason took the handoff, picked up 4 yards.
Billy Slavin's Jason Tate split behind Nielsen. Everyone's in tight. Quick handoff. Right Slavin's up the middle. Slavin's gets a couple.
Slavin's for about 2 tough yards. We're going to see Billy going both ways this year. I'm really impressed with Billy's aggressiveness. Billy's quite he's a linebacker. He's playing tailback, splitting time with Aaron Jones. Just a tough runner, tough football player.
Third and about 4 for San Juan.
Chris Singer splitting out wide to the right. David Lee wide to the left.
Back split behind Nielsen. Nielsen rolls right, looking downfield. He's got a receiver out there. Chris Singer, it's complete at the 30, the 20. He'll be run out of bounds at the 15-yard line.
That play opened up real well. That play was from the 46-yard line down to about the 14.
Chris Singer way out in front of everybody, just right underneath it. Perfect play. So the Broncos pick up a first down, and better yet, they're at the 15-yard line for the Emory Spartans. Strike quick.
Jens Nielsen, 1 for 1 from 38 yards. That's not a bad little average. They've been working on a couple of plays, things that look real familiar to me, Shelby. I have to tell you, I've been out for the last month, I guess. That one broke open. Chris Singer got out there. There was no one around him. Jens made the safe pass. If he led him a little bit more, might have had 6 on that one.
Singer's in motion. Slavin's in Tate in the eye behind Nielsen. Quick handoff right up the middle, Jason Tate. He'll get a couple.
Jason Tate, met in the middle by number 11. He was met by Joel Wilson, 6 foot, 285-pound junior linebacker.
Give him about 3 yards on the play, Danny.
Put a pretty good hit, but we'll take 3 yards. That's down to the 11 now.
2nd and 7.
Taco made by Wilson.
3rd and 4, and Coach Swenson hit him with the bomb. Jens Nielsen to Chris Singer for 38 yards.
Nielsen, the quarterback, 2nd down, 7 yards. Singer in motion to the near side. Hand off to Jason Tate once again. Move that stick forward another 3 or 4 yards. Danny, we're down to about 3rd and 4.
So Jason Tate's getting the tough yards. That's something, a position we were all kind of concerned about. Jason with the knee. He's got braces on both knees, as you can see. A lot of basketball players that play. Do.
3rd and 4th and 9, 3 backs behind Nielsen. There's the handoff to Slavin's. He'll get close.
No, he's close to the first down. He's close to the goal line. He's at least 5 yards away from it. It's going to bring up a 4th down. That's going to be an interesting call real quick. 4th down and about 1.
We have to remember we can't listen to this public address announcer. He's sort of a return rookie here. We'll talk about that in a minute. 4th and 1.
Press box club up here.
Billy Slavin's, Jason Tate once again doing most of the duties in the backfield. There's a handoff to Slavin's. Is he close?
He wormed, wiggled and wormed. Let's see if he got it. They're going to call time. It looks like unstack him. Let's see what the call's going to be.
We may see a measurement.
1st down, Emory County. No, he was short. Emory County takes over on downs.
Deep in their own territory, though. They'll operate from a little around the 5-yard line, 1st and 10.
A new name playing football in San Juan is a starting cornerback for the Broncos. That's number 35, Craig Black. He's not a new name to by any means to sports in San Juan. He's letterman in basketball, but Craig's came out and played real well in football. Here was a pro set. We expected to see a pro set by Emery.
Seth McCourt in the backfield, Jeff Kapinga, Devin Stilson, the quarterback. Receivers wide right and left.
Running the option. Pitches loose.
Sort of a slow developing option play, Danny. They may have lost one or two.
It was a slow developing play because big number 36 got a hand in there, Jason Tate, and slowed down everything. That was number
They 20. Did. They lost one.
It was number 25, Jeff Copings. He ended up with that. You hate to give him the minus yardage, but he's the one that has to have it. He took the option pass to Jason Tate, had hold of David Stilson, and Stilson saved his life by getting rid of the ball.
Once again, receivers wide right and left. Stilson turns the handoff
to the left side,
maybe gets three or four.
A little cross motion, opened up for about 3 or 4 yards. That was Copings again with the ball.
Is that what we're going with on the pronunciation? Sounds good to me. Jeff Copings.
3rd and 6, long down. Let's see what the Broncos are going to do here. Defense, San Juan can hold them here. They could be in good shape when they receive this punt. Not as good as they were on 4th down, though. 4th and 5.
Receivers wide right and left once again. There's another handoff, this time to Seth McCourt. He'll get close to a 1st down. I'm not sure if he made it.
He got up close. Jens Nielsen in with the tackle. Let's see. That's going to bring up. That is a 1st down.
They got it. So a little breathing room for Emery after a series of fits and starts, and they'll operate from the 17-yard line. 1st and 10. We'll get some of these receivers' names in here.
Well, we know number one over there on top. His name's Pugmire.
Pugmire. We've got Dell Stilson, number 43. The backs are Kapings, McCourt. The quarterback is Stilson. There's the handoff. It's to one of the backs. He'll pick up 3 or 4.
That's to number 42. That's McCourt again.
You know, if we had to rate uniforms, I'd have to say that the Emory Spartans have one of the most difficult uniforms to pick up numbers from.
The numbers are not.
Especially for a blind man like me.
They're real thin. It's kind of hard to pick. Hard to do that. That's a gain of 5 right off tackle that time.
Maybe a foot or two more, so we'll give them 2nd down and a little less than 5 yards. Again, receiver split wide right and left. There's one in motion. Backs are split wide behind Stilson. There's the quick handoff.
Quick handoff, but he ran right into that stunt defense Coach Duper ran. I think they stacked that up maybe a yard on that.
Just about.
Was that McCourt or that was Copings? Copings got it. Give him about 2 yards. We're looking at another 3rd down play here. Broncos need to toughen up right here.
Stumps are Spartans.
Split backs, Stilson the quarterback. Another handoff. Struggling for a couple.
I think they stopped this one short. He got a yard or two, maybe closer.
They needed 3.
That was McCourt. They're going to take a close look at this one. 4th down.
Fourth and less than 1 yard.
Got 2.5. We're going to see Wade Jukes. Coach Jimmy Jones, Emory County. Wade Jukes is a blue chip ball player. He's 6'4", 235 pounds. He kicks off, he punts. He is just an excellent athlete. I mean, with that kind of size, you know, just standing up in the middle has got to be tough. But there's a snap.
Oh, high step out of control. He'll have a hard time getting this one, Danny.
Greg Black's on him. There's a pass to a lineman.
Complete.
And it's stopped in the backfield. Number 22, Billy Slavens. And number 24, Jens Nielsen on that. That pass went to an end. Number 82 picked that pass up. 82 is Brian Gordon, and he lost about 4 yards on that one. We're going to have to put down a passer number 52 here.
As a footnote.
Yes.
So the Broncos take over once again in excellent field position. They really didn't have much damage done. They are still deep in Emory territory.
You know, Shelby, I've got to correct myself here. The ball, big fellers, we all know, but Spence, heady ball player, stayed right in there. He's 5'10", 185 pounds sophomore, made the stop. San Juan ball, 25 yards for a touchdown.
1st and 10. Nielsen brings the team to the line. Slavens and Tate in the eye. Everybody in tight. He'll keep it. There's a pitch out to him. Billy Slavens. He's to the 19-yard line.
Billy picked up 5 yards on that one. That's the option play that they ran the first time, the very first play of the game, except first play of the game, Jason Tate took it up the middle, picked up about 4 yards. That's the other play off of it, is the pitch to Billy coming around. Second and five.
Just about an even five. Second down and five. They're at the 19-yard line. Once again, everybody's tight. The backs are in the eye. Nielsen fakes. He spins. There's a long pass downfield for David Lee. He's got him. Touchdown.
David Lee, 19-yard touchdown pass.
Slanting toward the far goal line. Once again, Jens Nielsen on the money.
I think we're seeing a senior dominated team. You know, last year we were talking about the big senior line they had. And the big senior line, and also the juniors at the skill positions. But now we've got the skill positions covered by seniors, quarterbacks, wide receivers. We've also got some big seniors on the line. But we're going to see Chris Singer come in for the extra point attempt.
Jens Nielsen will hold. Singer the kicker. Here's the extra point attempt. The ball's down. The kick is up, and it's good. 7-0.
He's approaching the ball.
Here's his kick. Pretty good kick, short. Comes down at the about the 18-yard line. A Spartan's got it. He's immediately tackled by some hard-charging Broncos.
And there on top of it, number 47, and I think that is a young Mr. Palmer, Clint Palmer, on that tackle. Nice play. This kickoff team, the Broncos have what would amount to a track team on that kickoff team, but they've got everyone that's under 4'8 in the 40 on that kickoff team. And trying to get down on it before the backs can actually get started and score successfully.
While we've got a moment, we ought to at least try and set our offense here. We've got quarterback Devin Stilson. The backs are Jeff Copings, number 25, Seth McCourt, number 42. Van Wagner's in at one of the wide receiver positions, and also we've got Dale Stilson, the other wide receiver, split to the far side. Stilson keeps.
He's in trouble. He's getting out of it now.
Knocked out of bounds after a gain of a couple on the far side.
Looked like Brian. See who was on that tackle.
He really didn't appear to have any hope on that one. He was chased almost immediately.
Spence Harrison out there running him out of bounds again. Spence Harrison, Glenn Gaiman, defensive tackle and linebacker. He rolled to his right that time. He went back on a play action pass. Nothing developed. Rolled to his right. Got around in for about. They're going to give him about. What are we going to call that? 3.5.
We'll say 2nd and 7. We always round up for one side and down for the other. Remember that?
Yeah,
that's
right.
A whole football trick.
Going up for the Broncos and down for him.
2nd and 7.
Motion.
That's Buckmeyer in motion. Stilson the quarterback. There's the handoff.
Misdirection, and they ran right into a stunt. The ball's loose. Let's see who's got the football.
Broncos are cheering.
Broncos
says
they have it in. Jason Tate come up with a fumble on that play. Let's see if the officials are going to call it that away. Yes, they do. Jason Tate, fumble recovery. 4:47 to go in the first quarter. Jason Tate picked up a fumble.
The 26-yard line. The Broncos will be 1st and 10 after the fumble.
I think we might see a quick pass right here. We might see him go immediately to the air to try to push this one in the end zone in a hurry. Two touchdowns in the first quarter, and Broncos could feel awful. Not comfortable, but they could feel real good.
Tate and Slavens behind Jens Nielsen from the 26 after the fumble. There's the pitch to Tate. Option pass. He's looking downfield.
David Lee, there he is.
Just out of his reach.
Just overthrown. David Lee was out there. That's it. Okay, now we've seen that play. We've seen the option with the fullback running it. We've seen the option with the pitch. That time was the pitch, the option pass. David Lee broke open, passed just a little bit too tall. That play, Shelby, checking your memory, that scored a touchdown on that last year against the same Emory County team.
Was David Lee on the receiving end of that?
No, I think Kyle Meyer was.
I remember so many of those David Lee touchdowns last year. It's the one thing that sticks out. But we're back to 86, 7-0. There's the quick reverse handoff to Slavin, sort of a misdirection play. Slavin stopped for really no gain.
Third down and long. Third and 12.
So a loss on the play. near side, Lee to the far side, Baxter splits, Slavens and Tate, Nielsen the quarterback, there somebody jumped.
We've got motion, let's see who it was on. Could it be on our offense?
I don't know, Jason Tate put his hands to his head like I think I fell forward or something.
That's been a problem. The kids have been working so hard on learning plays and hitting that they've just have a tendency to maybe get going a little bit too quick.
So third and 11 and a half, third and 12 becomes third and 17.
Should I guess right here, Shelby, on the play? You want to guess on one?
You do the best guessing, I'll tell you that.
Let's guess on a screen pass to Chris Singerman.
You're our inside man this year. We may have to explain that in a minute. But backs are in the eye. There's Nielsen. He'll roll to his left. He's dropped for a loss.
Well, that one didn't get much of a chance to go anywhere. He was sacked by McCourt for a minus yardage of about 8 yards.
Set McCourt.
So now fourth down. Long yardage.
Linebacker came up the middle on that one. We've got a Bronco over here on the sideline laying down. Looks like Jimmy Swenson doing a little bleeding on us. Chris Singer's back to punt now from the 41-yard line.
So we got Chris Singer in there, number three.
We've quickly got a timeout called.
While we've got this timeout, we'll throw in one of those ever-popular commercials. You know, none of us like the thought, but summer will soon turn to a cool chill, and then, of course, winter right around the corner. And when those cool, chilly days arrive, it's nice to know your vehicle is going to start and run without giving you problems. And it will with a tune-up kit from your friendly Napa jobber, Blanding Motor Parts. They carry Champion and AC spark plugs, Napa belts and hoses, antifreeze, and a nice wax job to keep your car looking great this winter. Replace and repair while it's warm and save yourself a lot of unnecessary problems when the weather turns chilly. Blanding Motor Parts, your total car care center. Puzzle Rooney. You know, we need to tell people you got the Dodge running. That'd be a good commercial. Once again, the Broncos have the ball at the 41. Chris Singer set to punt on fourth down. Van Wagner back deep to receive. Here's Singer's punt. A good high kick to the near side. One bounce. Van Wagner lets it go by.
It's going to be down. Did David Lee get it before it went to the end zone? Looks like they're going to call it down.
Oh, boy. It looks like he's spotted at the one.
The 40-yard punt for Chris Singer down at the one by David Lee. Broncos are looking good right now. They could have done a little better on offense last time, but there's a lot of specialties that we're seeing a lot of things that look good.
3:17 left in the first period. 7-0. Sam Juan on top. The strength of a touchdown pass to David Lee.
Yes.
The Spartans are deep in their own territory. The ball is spotted, I would have to say, as close to the goal line as you could get.
It's on about the 1 foot line.
We just hope they don't have the famous Tony Dorsett 99 and a half yard play in their books.
Yes.
Well, they don't have Tony Dorsett either, but well, that's another story.
Dallas might not
either. Receivers are wide to the right and the left. We've got Van Wagner and Stilson. There's a handoff over the right side for really not much.
Stopped
maybe
up.
A yard of breathing room.
Stopped up in the middle. Looks like Jason Watkins in there on that tackle that time. Jason Watkins, Eric Falls, and who else could help? Jason Tate, of course.
Give them a couple of yards breathing room. It's second down and about 7.5-8 yards to go. The ball deep in the territory, though, on the two.
Jimmy Ray now playing defensive end for Jimmy Swenson.
Here's Bugmeyer in motion. Once again, a handoff. He'll play for quite a few yards on that carry.
He broke that one across tackle, and Spence Harris and Jens Nielsen on the stop.
Seth McCourt. That brings up third down and about a foot. So they've gotten themselves out of trouble in a way. Still within the 10-yard line, but just a foot to get another first down. Stilson comes to the near side. Van Wagner to the far side.
Quarterback
keeper, yeah.
Quarterback keeper for a first down. Looks like he got that down.
Stilson keeps for just what he needs.
Got the first down.
Give him about 3 or 4 yards on that.
32 line of scrimmage, about the 12.
We got 2 minutes left in the first period.
And that's where the clock has stopped.
First
down. Moving up the chains on the first down.
Buckmeyer's out wide to the left. Greg Black over here, man for man on him.
Backs are in the eye.
Motion.
Stilson, the quarterback. There's the pitch. He'll round the corner, but be dropped almost immediately.
Jimmy, Jens Nielsen, Craig Black, and Spence Harrison out. He picked up a couple yards on that one.
Jeff Copings gets credit for the play.
He went back against the motion. We've got a timeout by the officials. Let's see what their call is going to be there. They're all getting together discussing this one. First game of the year for them, too. We've all got to decide it. We've got a penalty flag.
A red flag? Oh, tell me about that.
We've got a red one, then. Let's see what the call is going to be against Emery. Let's see what they're going to say. In that last series, when they blitzed through and got San Juan, that's something that San Juan was really afraid of, was the blitz that Emery County threw at them in the fourth quarter last year of that game. And Coach Jones is going to remember that and come at them real hard with it. He's going to come at them real hard with it. It was successful that time. The penalty was after the play.
I haven't seen him signal the call yet.
Well, they only marked off 5 yards. Motion.
Against Emery.
Okay, now they've marked it back. Still first and 12. That doesn't make sense.
I don't know why they marked the motion back from the point where the ball ended up rather than the line of scrimmage, but...
We'll have to go with them.
You know, striped shirts, as you say.
Them zebras, you don't know what they're going to do.
It's first down and a little under 12 yards to go.
Quarterback
keeps again, right up the middle.
Jimmy Ray, Spence Harrison, and Glenn Diamond on the stop. Billy Slavin's in. Four Broncos in on top of that. Picked up, though, about 5 yards.
Second and six.
They're going opposite number 51, Jason Watkins. When he lines up in a gap, they're going to the gap he left. Jason's awfully quick, but with the stunts, he's got to go follow through with his stunt. And right now, they're going opposite him, and we've got a whistle. Officials timeout, I think. Once again, those zebras got to get together.
Well, we got that timeout. We might mention they've substituted a new wide receiver, Mission Park, now.
Do we have any restaurants or sponsors this year, by any chance? Or any food establishments? I mean, if they're worried about where they can go eat, we can suggest that.
Okay.
We got double wide receivers this time. Split the east side. Pugmeyer, the speed burner. He's on the east side of the field. Chris Singer's got him man for man.
Richard Chenoweth, the number 14, to the near side, another wide receiver in the game.
Great,
so we got Pugmeyer, Chenoweth.
Second.
Backs are McCourt and Copings, the quarterback.
Here's
still.
The dropback. Jason Tate's on top of him. There's a
it's
pass.
It's complete.
Knocked down.
No, no.
David Lee came up with a good play that time.
Right at the last minute.
Come out of nowhere. Make that easy. David's, well, David's playing free safety, and there's a reason for that. David has what you call a basic nose for the football. Somehow he ends up where the football is. It's just one of those things that last year he had those 8 touchdowns in the first 6 games. Somehow he gets in the middle of where the ball is. That's why he's playing free. We got 3rd and 6 now.
With the incomplete pass, once again, as Danny said, 3rd down, 6 to go.
About the 18-yard line of Emery County.
3rd and 6.
Stilson drops straight back. There's the pass. Oh, in and out of the arm.
Catch that. David Lee, nice hit. Chris Singer, nice hit over there.
Intended receiver Ben Wagner.
Caught him up in the air, put a good hit on him. Couldn't hang on to the ball. 4th down, Emery County Spartans to punt. The last time they made the punt play exciting. We saw a snap over the punter's head and a pass that was completed, but not for a first down. Jason Tate shedding those arm pads. He's going to be going back. Jason Tate's going back along with Aaron Jones. Ideally tonight, at least with Jason's knee the way it is, you really kind of hope Aaron Jones gets this punt. There's a snap.
The way Jukes gets this snap down. Good high punt.
Jason Tate.
Tate's got it across the 50 to the 45. He's along the near side down to the 36-yard line.
Jason Tate that time. About a 16-yard return. He's getting up. Broncos are going to go on offense.
We're down to 40 seconds left. Clock has stopped in the first period, 4-7-0.
Jason's coming out to take his break. Greg Black's going to get to see his first experience at fullback. We're looking at this combination. combination with Craig Black and possibly Aaron Jones in there. With those two, you'd have more speed than what a backfield should allow.
Three backs, Slavens, Black, Singer.
There's
the pitch to Singer. He'll be stopped after a gain of a foot or so. That bring up, maybe a foot less. Second down is still about 10 yards. We'll round that one up. Just back to the line of scrimmage. We may not get another playoff. We might. Down to 10 seconds. Clock is rolling. Get prepared for the gun here. Nielsen brings the team to the line. He will get one last playoff. There's the snap. There's the handoff.
Counter inside to Chris Singer, and he got contact.
Rolls off one.
Contact as soon as he got the ball, but he got hit.
Score. It's the San Juan Broncos 7, the Emery Sparks 7. Yards, maybe 6.5 yards to go. There's a pitch out to Bronco back.
Aaron Jones. That's the fellow we wanted to see. There's the outside speed. He didn't really get much. He got about four on that, but he didn't get what we were really looking for. He couldn't turn that corner.
That should bring a fourth down and just under 3 yards to go.
Well, you can tell that's a San Juan yard man over there. He just flipped it from 3 to 2.
Now it says 4. Seven to nothing the score. 11:25 yet to go in the second period of action. The Broncos with the ball. Nielsen brings them to the line on the fourth down and 2.5 yard play. Backs are split behind Nielsen. Receivers wide right and left. There's a flag.
We got motion.
Motion.
I think we're going to have a little motion on Emery County. That's going to be a first down for the Broncos.
So the offside play gives them 5 yards. Penalty. None of it gives them a first down, too. They're now at the 24-yard line. The benefit of the penalty, the first down. So just inside the 25-yard line. Singer to the near side, Lee to the far side. Backs are split behind Jens Nielsen. He'll pass. He's looking downfield. He's under pressure. There's a toss.
Short. It's intercepted.
Intercepted by Pugmire.
Pugmire got the interception.
He's up to the 40-yard line, the 50-yard line, and finally written down at the 45, knocked out of bounds there by, if you got a number, you can tell me.
Jason Tate on that stop.
We'll thank whoever did it. Intended receiver David Lee on the play. The pass just coming up short. Pugmire made the move. So Emery takes over on the strength of the interception in San Juan territory by 3 or 4 yards. First and 10. I think this is the closest we've gotten to viewing the Spartans in action so far this game. I don't know, we don't keep field position, do you? But this is some of the best field position they've had.
This is the only decent field position they've had. Broncos pinned them on the punts and they...
Receivers to the near side, far side. He drops straight back, a long pass. He's looking for Van Wagner. He's got it, knocked out of bounds at the 24.
Well, David Steelson can throw the ball, and we understand that they have some kids that can run. That was a nice pickup, about 20 yards.
They'll say he went out at the 25, but once again, right at the bounds line, he was pulling in. Richard Chenoweth to the near side, Pugmire to the far side. Backs are in the eye. Stilson, the quarterback.
Fumble on the snap. Well, let's see. Looks like they're saying Emery's got it, but that's an Emery player. So who do we believe?
No indication yet.
Second down. There's the indication. Emery got it back. Seven nothing. We still. This is quite a ball game.
They lost about a foot on the fumble. Second down, a little over 10 yards to go. There's Van Wagner in motion. You got Stilson to the near side. backs are in the eye behind Devin Stilson, number 7, the quarterback. Second and 10, drops straight back.
And there's Trent Harrison, Harry Claus, and Jason Watkins, all three on top of him. They were back as fast as he was.
Sack for a big loss. 10-yard loss on that quarterback sack.
Spence Harrison, Eric Laws, and Jason Watkins, all three back on that. A little stunt that Ronnie ran in the middle that time put everybody free coming through there.
Third and 20. And we've got a whistle. It'll dry the ball off. Rained all day, but you know, I was very surprised that it cleared up the way it did this afternoon from my weatherman's point of view.
When I come out of the locker room, I was down with the Broncos. We got a quick timeout. When I come out of the locker room with the Broncos,
I got to work Labor Day.
Well, I do too. Go up and get a little wood, maybe.
It is now third down and 20 for Emery.
Prevent defense.
Back split behind Stilson. There's the handoff. Big hole. Big hole for McCourt, but not enough to make up the difference in 20 yards.
That's going to bring up fourth and looks like about 7 or 8. This could be interesting. They got a big field goal kicker. Let's see what they're going to do. Here comes the regular defense back in. Straight defense again.
Fourth and 8, they'll go for it. With backs in the eye, receivers wide, right and left. A fumble. He's got it back. Stilson's got a pass out there way over Van Wagner's head.
Stilson was, I'll tell you what, Spence Harrison put a hit on
him. Good shot.
Devin Stilson, that is, he's not going to forget that one. That was a 5'10", 185-pound, 16-year-old sophomore that put a hit on a 6'5", 190-pound senior that he's going to remember next time he goes back to pass.
So with the incomplete pass, the change of downs, the Broncos will take over from their own 20 to 23-yard line. First and 10, San Juan. Singer in lead here to the near side. Backs are in the eye behind Jens Nielsen. There's the pitch back to Billy Slavens to the near side. He rounds the corner, slips and falls, and is immediately tackled.
Lost his footing. I think he got a couple of yards on that. Lost his footing, but he still had a couple of them.
He crossed the 25. He'll get a couple out of it. Second and 8. Once again, 7-0 the score as the clock winds down to 8:35 in the second quarter. Things got off to a quick start, and they've kind of settled in to this one. Once again, receivers to the near side. Backs are split. Here's a quick pass out to Lee. He's got it. Complete. Dancing around. He'll get a
first down.
Close to a first down. They spotted, yes, a yard or two beyond the first down marker.
San Juan flooded that time. They went with Chris Singer. David rolled right under him. It was wide open.
So from the 35-yard line, first and 10. 7-0. Slavens and Craig Black behind Jens Nielsen. Receivers are in tight. Here's the snap.
Counter, the ball's loose.
Fumble.
Chris Singer, we've got a fumble down there.
San Juan recovers. But a big loss. All the way back to the 29-yard line.
It's about 9 to 7 yards. Who are we going to give that 9 to 7 yards to? I have to give that one out.
I'm afraid. Normally the man in charge takes the hold of that one.
I think Jim's bought that one.
Lee to the near side. Singer to the far side. Nielsen drops straight back.
There's a screen.
Complete, but immediately read. Brought down.
Let's see who caught that. That was set up. You know, if they're looking up, they should. They should be throwing a flag
right
on that one. That
was Jason intended. Watkins on the screen.
That was intended for Chris Singer, and Jason jumped up. I'm not real sure what he was thinking. And they didn't call anything.
Maybe we shouldn't announce that one over the public address.
Let's not say that over the public
address. To the offensive line.
Number 51. one on the receiving end. Third and long.
Once again, not very much on it. Third and long. Nielsen drops straight back, looking downfield. Now he'll roll to his right. He's under a little pressure. There's a long pass downfield.
Chris Singer, he's intercepted.
Picked off.
For it, and it's picked off again.
At the 49-yard line, 48-yard line by the Emory Spartans. Well, there's always paybacks, you might say.
Yeah.
But Emory takes over. Just a few yards in their own territory. The defender and the receiver were very close. In fact, both appeared to almost handle the ball at the same time, but Emory came up with it.
Well, they both go down with it. They're still fighting for it. It's offensive ball, but he took it away.
In this case, he got it.
Emory County, first and 10 from their own 47 and a half.
Here's Van Wagner in motion. Backs are in the eye. Dropping straight back, Stilson looking downfield. There's the completion to Van Wagner at the 45 of the Broncos. Immediately brought down. Slavin's in on the tackle.
Chris Singer on
then
the first hit.
Singer in on the
down.
First hit.
Really with the assist.
Danny, we might explain to everybody that you're providing us a lot of insight this year from a much more inside point of view. We're fortunate to have you assisting this year in some of the program. And
I've been working with the kids since they started two of
these. We'll be interested in some of your comments as the season progresses from that point of view this year.
Well, it's kind of hard. I've been working with the line.
Quick drop pass off the shoulder pads. Of
he was open. He was open, had the ball in his hands just to let it slip through.
Devin Stilson to Dell Stilson for the incomplete pass.
Hands, but Devin Stilson just good. That ball went right through his hands. I've been working for Coach Giffer is the head defensive coach. Coach Swenson, of course, is the head coach. He spends a lot of his time with the offense, so he spends his time with everyone. But I've been concentrating on working with my good group of kids. So far, they're hanging in there pretty good.
Third down, short yardage. There's the handoff right up the middle. He'll get close to a first down. If he is, get it, he'll be very close. I'm afraid they got it.
They got that one, yeah. He went right through our right side tackle there. And picked that one up. That was McCord. Is that McCord? Number 42?
That's Seth McCord.
Let's
move the sticks once again. They're in San Juan territory at the 41-yard line. Stilson to the near side. The receiver to the far side. Backs are split behind Devin Stilson. Here's one in motion. It's Pugmire. There's the pitch out to McCord. He's around the far side. Breaks one tack. Oh, no, he's down.
He got down. David Lee came up real strong that time. Put a pretty good hit on him. They cracked back that time on Jason Tate. Question that block. That's not what you call your basic good block to hit him from the side like that. We'll have to watch that one.
Spot the ball at the 40-yard line. Second down and long eight. Clock down to about 5:15 to go. 7-0, the Broncos on top on the basis of the long touchdown pass in the first quarter. Backs are in the eye, receivers to the near side and the far side. Stilson barks out the calls.
Straight
he drops
back.
Straight back, quick pass. It's complete. Van Wagner, the receiver, the 34-yard line.
Picked up about six on that.
So far, the Broncos, when they did give him a pass, they're right there to make the stop, though. Good coverage.
That's bringing up third short, though, and they keep putting, really, Emory County in a position that they want to be in. Right now, Emory County's controlling the ball. San Juan, the last couple of offensive sets, hasn't looked real good. You know, the interceptions, they haven't looked real good. They had a couple of sacks. Emory County's hanging on to the ball, but they're on the short end on the scoreboard.
Pugmire to the near side, Stilson to the far side. Backs are split. There's the handoff. Good for the first down. McCourt with the first down yardage. Down to the 30. They'll move the sticks. They'll spot the ball once again at the 30-yard line, first and 10. Clock will stop as they do that. 4:20 to go. The ball is marked. We're ready for first down. Van Wagner to the near side. Another receiver far left. Backs are in the eye behind Devin Stilson. Here's Van Wagner in motion. There's the snap, drops straight back, looking downfield, looking for that receiver to the far side, way over his head, out of bounds.
He can be real glad that was over his was hit. Craig Black was out there playing that one perfect. He came up, if he'd have drilled that ball, Craig Black would have had 6 points. He came up in real good shape, timed everything. It's just a good thing. Stilson threw that one over his head. He was looking at a touchdown all the way. If Craig Black gets the ball in that position, there's nobody out here.
No, there's nothing between him.
Nobody will catch him either. They talk about the speed Emery County has, but David Lee, Craig Black, Jens Nielsen, and Chris Singer is a pretty fair relay team. Second and 10.
Stilson with the play. Here's the snap. He'll fake one. They come back under pressure. There's the screen.
And here comes the Broncos. The blockers are up. They're going to gain some yards on this one.
They'll gain about 8. Well, Danny,
we had a fumble.
May have been caught on that one.
Well, fumble recovery that time by David Lee, it appears. Fumble on the tackle. We know when they go into that pileup, it's hard for us to see what's going on in there.
And it is the San Juan ball, first and 10.
San Juan recovered a fumble.
Still 7-0, 3:45 to go. Lee comes to the near side, Singer to the far side. Backs are split behind Jens Nielsen. He drops straight back, he's bumped, there's a pass, it's wide open in and out of the hands.
Threw it behind him, just a little bit behind Billy Slavens. We're gonna see that ball in the air just a bunch tonight.
The incomplete brings up second down and 10. Slavens will come out of the game.
Aaron Jones in. Chris Singer now, he's slot. He's coming to the left to this side. Aaron Jones in. Pitch quickly
pitch
to Aaron Jones. He cuts inside one.
Oh, he's got some speed on this one.
Cuts inside another one. Gets hammered and hit that time. He did pick it up, bring it back to where they're going to have a third and short, though.
6-7 yards on the carry, but still brings up third and short.
He made two nice cuts on that one to cut inside of blocks. He kept trying to get to that outside. I never really could quite make the outside the way you want to see him do it, but he ended up with about 7 or 8 yards on that play.
That will bring up third down in about 2. They're at their own 32-yard line with third and 2. Backs are in the eye. Everyone's in tight. Nielsen, handoff.
Billy Slavens
Billy
with
Slavens.
A hard 3 yards, but he got it. He got
boy.
The first down. That's what I was telling you earlier. Billy Slavens, for 175-pounder, is all that any defensive man wants to try and take on one-on-one. It reminds me a little bit. He doesn't quite have the breakaway speed like Kyle Murray had, but he's every inch as tough and 20 pounds heavier. He will let you know if you've been hit.
First and 10, we're down to 2:38 left in the first half of action here in the San Juan Broncos opening game here in Blanding against the Emory Spartans.
Greg Black in the backfield now, fullback.
Black and Slavin Singer coming in motion to the near side. There's the handoff to Billy Slavin. Once again,
stacked up right on the line.
Not much.
He was met by number 79, and that's Mr. Holliday. Mr. Holliday is 6'6". 162 pounds, and I don't call anybody that big, mister.
This morning I call him Monster.
Monster, well. Okay, here comes a little prevent defense, looks like by the Emory County Spartans. They're going with a 4-deep umbrella, 4 linemen.
Black and Slavin split behind Nielsen.
There's a reverse to David Lee, and he's got a lot of
room. A lot of room.
He's might get up. He's up close. He's got the
down. He's breaking free into Emory territory. Knocked out at the 41-yard line. Danny, you're right. A lot of room.
He's got him. Is that a flag?
They're bringing it back
a few
yards. But
15-yard gain. No, that's enough for the first down.
They didn't say he was knocked out just sooner than we thought, so placed the ball at the 49-yard line for the Emory Spartans. A minute and 45 left to go. Lee to the near side. Backs are split. Here comes Singer in motion toward the near side. dropping straight back. There's a lateral back to Chris Singer, long downfield, but way out of reach of his intended receiver, Jimmy Swenson.
Chris, defense of that pass, Chris threw that ball where he wanted. Jimmy had coverage deep, and he had coverage short. Chris threw that away very wisely. 38 to go in our first half, 7 for the Broncos, and it's awfully dark on the Emery County side. No lights on the board. No points on the board. Glenn Guyman coming over the ball.
Second and 10. Three backs behind Jens Nielsen.
Power play off tackle. That's why it goes in motion.
No, there's the snap. There's the handoff to Craig Black. Craig Black will break free of one. He slows down a minute 25. Some kind of fumble in the play. Everybody jams up. Do they keep it?
Fumble snap. Let's see. Second and long. Broncos are going to keep that one. Glenn Guyman is very quick. Shelby, your backup newsman on weekends is extremely quick. Sometimes he...
hope he's durable, that's why.
He's been known to actually get out of there blocking before the quarterback gets the ball. And that happened that time.
Second and 11. Straight back, Nielsen.
There's a
quick pass.
And
it takes off.
And we've got it picked off.
Rolls out of a couple of tackles. He'll get into San Juan territory. Number 56 for the Emory Spartans. That's Brian Spears with the interception.
We're going back and forth a lot in the middle of the field. Nobody's getting in the end zone.
We may be happy with our 7-0 here at halftime.
We might be proud of it. That's the thing. We're real proud of it.
Spot the ball once again at San Juan's 49-yard line.
39 seconds. There's a prevent defense.
Receivers wide right and left, back split behind Devin Stilson. Everybody drops back deep. Straight back, looking downfield, under pressure. There's a short pass picked off.
David Lee in the middle of the field. He's picked one off.
Stilson kind of shaky when he got up and left the field after that one, under a lot of pressure.
The way he threw that ball, he should. He kind of threw an end over almost.
28 seconds left to go. We've seen the ball change hands, I think, in the last 2 minutes, so two or three times here.
And we've got a timeout on the field called by the Broncos. We've got 28 seconds. Coach Swenson wants to get this one in the end zone.
Well, we've got this timeout. We'll take a break for station identification. You're listening to the KUTA High School Game of the Week.
I'm over here looking through the window. This messes you up. That's nasty. You got to open that window and look through there, Shelby.
I cannot read numbers at all.
Well, if you open that window, that glass is terrible.
Anybody got a break? Yeah. Well, it clears up a little. Of course, I need my drops, too. We're back with 28 seconds left to go. The Broncos 7-0. The David Lee interception at the 30-yard line. Nielsen's handoff comes to
Aaron Jones.
No gain, though. Stopped at the 30.
Tried to get outside. Coach Winston tried to cross him up, called the timeout, sent him back in to prevent the defense against the pass. Made the run, and we've got 12 seconds, 11, 10. I think we're going to let the clock run.
People are starting to head that way, at least, toward the locker room with 2-1, and there's the gun, ending the first half.
Now we're looking at
to start the third quarter of action. Once again, the Broncos lead 7-0. There's the kick. High, kind of short, comes down to Spartan at about the 16-yard line.
Fumble.
There's a fumble.
Broncos, it's still flying loose. Let's see who's got it. The official kicked that one a little.
We'll wait for the signal. It appears Emery may have gotten it back. They did.
With an assist to the official. We'll have to give him assist. Shelby, Coach Dennis Jones asked me to announce that one of the favorites around here, the alumni football game, will be played September the 13th, and those wishing to participate should contact the school to find their representative. Also, 1 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, or this afternoon when you hear this, the JV team will be playing the Cortez Panther JV team.
That's the Broken Bones and Contusions Bowl, I think.
Right.
We got Stills, Dale Stilson, the receiver to the near side. Another receiver, I think that's Van Wagner, to the far side. Backs are in the eye. Devin Stilson, number seven, the quarterback. Quick pass, it's complete. He's broken one tackle. He's up to the 30, the 40, the 50. He'll be dragged down finally at the 38, 37-yard line. And if we can give credit, we will.
Receiver on that, number 34, wasn't it?
Van Wagner. That's who I thought. I have to confess, though, that
41-yard gain.
With the uniforms and the lighting, it's almost impossible to read some of these Spartan numbers. A couple of Broncos hustling out real quick. The completion puts the ball in Bronco territory. Once again, it's at the 39-yard line. First and 10, Emery. Backs are in the eye. Receivers to the near side and the far side. Straight back. There's the pass. Picked off.
Picked off. He's got a wall of blockers coming down the left side. He's not going all the way, I don't think, but he's going to go down to about the 24. Fumble the ball there, and it's covered by Emery, but his foot was out of bounds. That's got to be San Juan ball at about the 23. San Juan that time in a good defense, did a little cherry pick and picked that one off. Jens Nielsen standing there, really couldn't believe that he had it.
Spot the ball at the 24-yard line. First and 10 for San Juan. We closed out the second quarter with quite a few turnovers. We begin the third quarter on the same note. Just a lot more excitement to these.
Yes, at least.
It's first and 10 for the Broncos now.
Lance Shumway's in the game quarterbacking now. He's a backup quarterback. I don't know if Jess took a hit or he's got an equipment problem, it looks like.
Singer in motion.
Hand off to Billy Slavens, and he's wrapped up by the big man in the middle, Halliday. No blocking on that side.
Loss on the play. Back to the 26, 27-yard line. Let's get that equipment problem straightened out and get our first team back in.
They're still working on it right now. Coach Jones looks like a helmet problem. I believe I'd have to grab a helmet from someone else and get back in there. Lad's been working a little bit with the first group, but Lad is a sophomore, 15 years old. He saw a little varsity action last year.
Slavinson taking the backfield. There's a fake, the handoff right
Tate
in the middle.
With a stiff arm, and he's going to go for a first down. Jason Tate that time with a lot of mileage out of a straight dive play. He's up for a first down, I would think. Looks like 9-yard gain on that play.
Knocked out of bounds beyond the marker.
They're going to say first down San Juan or not. Let's see.
Well, they have to.
Move the sticks, yes, first down.
And now Jess Nielsen's back in the game. Slavens comes out. Aaron Jones in the game, too.
Lad Shumway did a good job coming in cold, handling two snaps when all you're expected to do is go to the dance after the game. Pretty good job by Lad. .43 to go. Broncos knocking on the door.
Aaron Jones and Jason Tate in the backfield. Jens Nielsen once again the quarterback. There's the handoff to Aaron Jones. He breaks one. He'll get a couple.
Aaron Jones for about three on the left side. They're in the 3-yard territory now. Here comes Billy Slavens in for Aaron Jones. Maybe a half a step in speed difference, but Billy's going to pack a punch.
Second down and just about 7 yards to go. The ball is spotted just beyond the 10-yard line, call it the 11.
Little equipment problem out there again. Jens Nielsen again with some equipment problem getting the
tighten some nuts and bolts here and get things going.
Valuables. I guess David Lee must be carrying a mechanic's pouch with him out there. He was working on Jens' helmet. We're back in business now, 10:26. The officials were graciously give us a little time to fix that helmet. San Juan knocking on the door now. They're getting serious with this threat. Second and about seven.
Tate and Slavens in the eye behind Jens Nielsen. Formation, tight formation. There's a handoff right up the middle. Billy Slavens for a couple.
Billy Slavens over the right side. He's running behind Don Hammond and Eric Laws on that side. Opened up a whole gain of about three or four more. This is the tough yards, maybe four of them. Maybe three. Two and a half.
Second down and off.
We're going to get a little worried here in a minute about the yards.
Third and five.
2 yards. Third down and five to the Broncos.
Third and five. Big down right here.
From a about the 9 yard line. They can get a first down in close. Third and five. Baxter in the eye, Singer in motion. Once
there's
again.
Jason Tate, touchdown.
Oh boy, touchdown right up the middle.
Jason Tate right over the left side. About 9 yards for a touchdown.
So to heck with the first down, we'll take the six. It's 13 to nothing. Sam Juan on top.
Shelby, I'll have to tell you, when I was in the locker room at halftime, we were all discussing a few things. Coach Swenson turned around and said, we haven't been running our straight dive plays. We're going to get right into it. We've been trying too much fancy stuff. We're going to run the ball and run it at them. And that's exactly what the Broncos did, ran it right in the end zone.
Singer to try the extra point attempt, and Nielsen will hold.
Jim Langston in for the snap.
Low kick, but good. Fourth one here. He's been getting
plenty of height, but he's not getting that much depth right now.
Van Wagner there's back to receive. Better. There's a long kick you want. Van Wagner will take it at the 15. He's to the 20. He's to the 25, the 30. That's where he'll be stopped.
Stopped by about 7 or 8 Broncos. That time, a couple of Broncos flying through the air kind of upset because of missed tackles, but they slowed him down, allowed the rest of them to catch up and do the damage. We've got somebody on the field still down. It's Emery Spartan. He's getting up real slow.
A little slow out there.
An official
like,
timeout.
That's one of them, Van Wagner. That's their leading receiver in the ball game. Greg Van Wagner, 5'9", 155-pound senior. Hugmeyer coming in for Van Wagner, it looks like.
Van Wagner left the field under his own power. He just had a little hitch or limp or something.
Looked like a little bit of maybe a cramp or a minor twist. Wide right, wide left, they're split the pro set.
Hugmeyer to the near side, receiver wide left. Baxter split,
quick dive
hand off
play.
Over the right.
Fumble on the play, fumble on
another
the play.
Another turnover.
And Jason Tate once again with a quick turnover. Jason Tate on the recovery. 9:04, go 27 seconds after a touchdown, Jason Tate recovered the fumble.
So the same story, a new chapter. Turnover, Broncos in Emery territory, 9:04 to go in the third period. They lead 14 to nothing. Last time we had a turnover, they capitalized.
Well, let's see if it holds true. Coach Swenson said he wanted to get away from the fancy stuff and run it at them, and that's what he's done the first drive. Let's see what happens this drive.
Tight formation, Baxter split behind Jens Nielsen. They're set, here's the snap, there's the handoff. Billy Slavens, only a couple.
He got a couple. Billy got hit in the back that time real bad. Let's see how they
there's
get
a flag.
Up. We got a flag down and somebody a little extracurricular activity. Not sure who it is.
Another flag, Danny.
Hey, we got flags coming everywhere. Lots
reds, yellows, all kinds of colors.
It's good to see the, you know, maybe I shouldn't say this, but I'm going to. It's nothing like seeing the aggressiveness. They're being very aggressive right now. Both teams are doing a lot of finger pointing. The only fingers that count are the officials, and it looks like San Juan's backing up. Stupers out on the field.
Emery cheered the first flag. They appeared to feel the Broncos started whatever the altercation was. Then another flag went down when things got, in the second step, the push back.
It's going to be, that should have been after the play, shouldn't it? I would think it was after the play. If it was, it'll be second and a whole bunch. Now we're going to get back into the fancy plays again. We're going to get cute on them again. See some bootlegs and some rollouts and option passes, a little bit of everything right here. 15-yard major penalty, no signal yet. Let's see, here comes a double. Throwing a double major penalty on them. The officials are over now explaining it to the coaches. They're going to have first down in about half a mile to go. Personal foul and a face mask, it looks like.
Let's say, how about 40 yards? How's that sound?
No help for a stepper.
So with 40 yards for a first down, Nielsen's got back split. Lead on the near side, he drops straight back. A quick pass over the middle. Slavin's got the pass, but he'll be dropped immediately for a loss. Try 42 yards now to go.
That was a little flare out there talking about running it during halftime. Those are the kind of completions you really just don't want to hear about.
waits. He rolls to his right. There's a long pass downfield. It'll be way out of reach of David Lee.
That was about the right place to throw that ball, though. You have to throw that one out in front of everyone where your man's the only one that might have a chance to receive it. You know, the interesting thing about that play right there, David had two men covering him, and supposedly the fleet-footed Emery County defensive backs, and David Lee was looked like he was gaining a half a stride on him all the way down the field. So, you know, maybe we've overestimated a little bit of the so-called quickness and speed of Emery County. Eric Laws
getting out of the game.
Hobbling off the field. Sean Sanford in the game now, playing offensive guard.
Backs are in the eye. Two receivers wide to the far side, wide right. There's a pitch back to Slavin. Slavin's around the right side. He's got some good yardage, and he's up over the 50-yard line.
He's got about 15 of the 40 that we needed.
Just shy of the 50.
Give him 15 of that 40 right there. Now we're looking at fourth down and good punt position. Guess that's about all we got out of that one. Broncos had another turnover that time, Shelby, inside their opponent's 35-yard line. A couple of penalties, though. You can't really afford to lose those kind of chances. Not at 14-0. This game's still well within reach of both teams, and you just can't afford to miss those kind of opportunities.
Fourth down and 30 to go, the exact calculation.
This is one of those plays. Let's look at Marcus' line of scrimmage at the 23. This is one of those plays where you hope your punter really gets into it so you can at least get past first down yardage.
Chris Singer to punt. He'll set up at his own 35-yard line.
29 yards, isn't it, to get to the first down?
Might not even punt far enough to get a first down. Here's the kick.
Number three, Chris Singer.
Good long punt.
He moved it. Chris can't. He can't boom him. And the man fielding, he's hit him.
And he's down, Danny, at the one.
He's hit him. And Craig Black and David Lee. Craig Black on top of him to smother that one. Craig Black, David Lee, man, him. The ball carrier, the Emery County Spartan really shouldn't have touched that ball. Should have let it come to the end zone. He picked it up on about his 5-yard line. His momentum carried him down to where David and Craig put a pretty good hit on him. Pinned themselves in a hole.
They'll officially spot the ball inside the five at about the 2.5-3 yard line.
Chris
first and 10 Emery.
Chris hit that ball about 50 yards.
Up and deep. So the Spartans take over for another time, very deep in their own territory after an excellent punt by Chris Singer. First and 10 from their own 3-4 yard line. Devin Stilson, the quarterback, there's the handoff.
Trying to run a little bit of power right off tackle, but Broncos are there stacking that one up. When that one unfolds, we're going to see Clint Gaiman and Jason Watkins getting up from the bottom of that one. Maybe Billy Slavin's in there, too.
That will bring up second down in about 8 from the 5. Over the 5-yard line. Receivers wide, right, and left. Stilson straight back, looking to the near side. He's got Pugmire now off his fingertips. At the 50-yard line, just a fingertip away. Good coverage, too.
We saw his speed last year, and we just saw it again right there. That pass looked like it was too long, too tall for him, but he just turned the afterburners on and almost made a completion out of it. That's really the time to do that. You know, second and long from inside your five is rare back and throw.
Nielsen, Singer, and Lee all back there with him, but just off the fingertips. So it brings up third down and 8.
Straight run back again. There's
to the far side. There's a completion.
He's going to be close to a first down. I think they're going to spot it up by the first down marker. He might have it.
Brought down by number 24, Spence Harrison.
Very close. Yeah, there we go.
First and 10. Everybody's getting out of that hole. They were way back there.
They're at the 15-yard line now, so they're a little improvement.
Well, they've got punting room now.
6 minutes.
14-0 our score. Broncos on top.
Inside 6 minutes in the third period. Here's a receiver in motion. It's Pugmire. There's Stilson back. There's the handoff up the middle.
Football. San Juan has it again. I think the Broncos are on top of it.
Broncos capitalize on another turnover.
I think Jason Tate again. Let's see. We've got some players on the field right now. It looked like one of the Broncos reached out with one arm and kind of tried to make a one-arm tackle, grab the ball. I think Jason Tate had the recovery.
The Emery Spartan is injured, is being helped off the field.
Not sure right now whether it was Jason Watkins or Jason Tate, but we'll just leave it at this. Jason recovered that fumble, and right now the Broncos are in business inside the Emery County 20-yard line.
First and 10 from just about the 15-yard line.
This is what they call a twin formation.
Both Lee and Singer to the near side, split backs. There's a flag.
See what that one was? That one looked like maybe a delay. Delay or motion as quick as that one was thrown.
Nevertheless, it's going to be first and 15, at least.
Motion. They're calling motion. Somebody, I had to guess. No, backfield in motion. That was just a, was that backfield in motion signal or just illegal motion? I had to guess on that one. I'd say Ryan could either move or put his hand down or pick it up.
And that brings up first down and 15 from just beyond the 20-yard line.
San Juan needs to capitalize. They've already left one opportunity to get away to take care of this one.
Singer in motion to the near side. There's the handoff. Oh, breaks a couple. He'll get the 5 yards back at least.
Aaron Jones for five.
There's another flag.
We've got a flag and a face mask.
Oh!
I think we've got a face mask call on number 43.
Very quickly thrown.
Dell Stilson. I think he had a face mask.
I believe we've got a face mask on number 20. Aaron Jones is brought down. I believe the Spartans grabbed hold of his mask there.
Indeed is a face mask. There's no option. That's an automatic.
The Spartans are backing up.
They're talking to Jens Nielsen, so evidently it's on the, we know it's on the Emery County Spartans. Looked like our ankle, possibly a face mask. Some kind of a roughing penalty, though. It went down on the tackle.
Here comes the official's march.
Down inside the 10.
About the 8.5 yard
there
line.
There is. There's a face mask call.
Sure was.
Face mask on number 43. That's Stilson, one of the Stilson brothers. We're looking second down. First down. We've got a problem on our third numbers.
One of the fans in the stands right in front of us seems to think they should give a first down, and I do too.
It should be an automatic first down. That being the case, they need to move those yard markers. See what they're talking about now. Yeah, we're going to discuss again.
We'll have a brief discussion. It would be first and goal rather than first and 10. It will be.
What a penalty of that nature. We'll have to discuss that one. I thought a penalty of that nature might be an automatic, but maybe it's not.
Well,
either way, we'll take it. Second and 3.
Split backs and two receivers to the near side, Singer and Lee. There's the quick handoff inside, spinning down to the 5. There's another fumble.
And a fumble. Billy Slavens fumbled the ball, and Emery County Spartans have recovered it.
What's the word for this? Fumbleitis? 5 yard line.
That's two opportunities now in this period. The Broncos have had the ball deep in Emery County territory and haven't been able to capitalize. They need to capitalize on those. Right now, they need a tough defensive, tough defensive team right here. Emery County gets this out, gets any kind of drive going, it's going to give them confidence. And we still got 5 minutes, 6 seconds to go in the third period.
14-0, the score of the Broncos on top, but once again they turn it over, and at the 5 yard line, the Emery Spartans are now operating with receivers wide, right, and left.
Billy Slavin's getting his first rest of the night. I think that might have had a lot to do with it.
Fumble again. Another fumble. And still fumble. I think San Juan's going to come up with a touchdown out of this one.
Let's see. It's either a touchdown or a safety. It's a safety.
There we go.
In the end zone, San Juan with a safety. We'll take that one, 16-0. We'll take all those we can get.
You know, the thing I like about broadcast, there's the whistle. Here's the free kick.
He hits a pretty good kick.
Back.
Greg Black at the 30, the 35 coming to the near side. He's to the 37, 38. There's where he's dropped.
And Broncos had a good chance to get him a block. Mr. Blocks, he got trapped back. Not a lot of return, but you got to be happy when you've got the ball with a 16-point lead. 4:41 to go in the third period. First and 10, San Juan.
4:41. As Danny said, in the third period. First and 10 for San Juan after the free kick. They returned it to the 38. Singer and Lee in tight to the near side. There's Singer in motion. Backs are split behind Jens Nielsen. First and 10. There's the snap. A fumble. Jens will cover it, though, at the 31. Bad handoff exchange. He gets the ball back.
Have to give Jens about a minus. Quite a minus four on that.
I'd say more like minus seven.
Maybe minus seven. His average, well, now that's hanging in there pretty good. He had one missed sack tonight for a minus seven, so he's doing all right. Nobody ever said that he was a, you know, a halfback.
Second down, 17, 18 yards to go after the miscue.
I mean, after all, Shelby, you watch that team in Texas, not the Oilers, but the other one. They're both
on tomorrow night. We have to promo that here in a minute and talk about it.
They got a guy that's used to them minus yards. His name White.
Yeah, I know. I love the guy. I'm doing a duty tonight, I guess. There's split backs. Nielsen rolls to his right. Kind of wobbly pass. Singer's got it.
First down. No,
Danny. That's the other marker.
I'm getting too hopeful, I guess.
Really? We get back the loss.
Up to the original line of scrimmage. Chris Singer. On a really a floater. That was one that they'd be glad they got away with.
That will bring up third down in about eight. You know, I hope everybody understands that we've done this for several years now and we can get away with having a good time with some of these broadcasts. We could tell the story about the first time we ever did a broadcast.
Fighting the Wasps. That was a good one.
We now pack a can of Raid when we go to Moab. Third down and eight for the Broncos. They lead 16-0. 2:56, the clock is rolling. Lee to the near side, Singer to the far side. Backs are split behind Nielsen. They're set. Here's the snap. There's the handoff
right up the middle. Not much. Jason Tate.
Stacked up almost immediately at the goal at the line of scrimmage.
Gonna have to kick this one out. Jim Langston coming in. He does the boot snap for the Broncos. Chris Singer hit one 50 yards last time. Let's see what he can do this time. Coming on the field a little bit late, Rodney.
And he got the all-important height, too, in that kick that allowed David Lee to get down and stop things cold.
David Lee and Craig Black can almost get under it, whether it's got height or not. Rodney Hickman, he's on that punt.
They're set. Here's Singer awaiting the snap. He'll kick from his 28-yard line. There's the punt. Not as good as the last one, but a good high kick. It bounces. San Juan bounces. It will go out at the 24-yard line.
So, 36-yard kick, that's still a good kick. We'll take that one and be happy. We got a flag down, and what's the call? Looks like it's against the Broncos.
Procedure call.
I'm not sure. They're discussing it with the captain from Emery County. Haven't seen really any indication. These officials haven't looked a whole lot on this. Penalty signals, they're kind of weak in that area.
I said procedure. I thought I caught the initial call, but I'm not sure. Now we're moving the ball down to the...
Well, it to be honest with you, it would make having the ball where he had it, you know, where he's going to have it first and 10. It's a procedure penalty. Having it first and 10 from your own 24 is not bad. He's been pinned by punts inside his five twice tonight, and I don't guess Coach Jimmy Jones wanted to take much of a chance of having that happen again. That was a 36-yard kick, which is a good kick for a high school athlete. For Chris, though, Chris usually booms him a little further. You know, we're all happy with that yardage, but Chris would probably like to have a chance to hit that one again.
From the 26-yard line, first and 10, Van Wagner comes to the near side. Stilson to the far side. Backs are split behind Devin Stilson, number 7. There's the snap. Drops straight back, looking downfield. Long pass downfield, way over his receiver's head. Number 85, the intended receiver, Kelly Mortensen. I remember that name.
He's a big boy. 6 foot, 175-pound tight end. Second and 10. Emery County Spartans with the ball.
16-0, a minute 47 to go in the third period. A game of quite a few turnovers. Did you get a chance to do any statistic work at halftime? I know you were down doing your coaching duties, but I was asked in the stands by one of our fans how things compared statistics-wise.
San Juan had the edge in yardage, you know, considerable edge in yardage. The big problem was the San Juan turnovers. They turned over. They had the three interceptions. They had a fumble. You turned the ball over four times in one half and got a 7-0 lead. You've got to be happy with it.
On the second and 10 play, Devin Stilson, apparently a bad exchange between the center. He fumbled and recovered. There was a fumble. He recovered his own, recovered the ball for a loss of one. That will bring him third and 11.
Not the best thing you can say about the first half, like I say, is that we're ahead. We were ahead at halftime. The gents threw a pass off balance. We got a timeout on the field by the Spartans. He had thrown a pass off balance.
Minute 10 on the clock. Once again, 16-0. The Broncos on top. They're looking at third down and 11. The Emory Spartans are after the timeout.
There's a prevent defense, too. Three down linemen. Jason Watkins in the middle. Defensive ends rushing. Reverse.
Here's the reverse. Van Wagner, the runner. Fumble.
Looks like Van Wagner might have got it back. Either way, it's not a first down. David Lee holding his hand. He had a handful of jersey. You wonder if maybe he didn't hurt a thumb.
36, Jason Tate. David Lee was there also.
Jason Tate's down on the field.
Jason Tate's down, and he's crawling. He's hurt. I think we've got the time that you wanted right now. Jason Tate has had a bad knee. Looks like they're working on the knee now. Maybe a cramp.
While we check this injury, the San Juan Pharmacy in Blanding and Monticello has a new selection of great toys in stock, toys that any child would be pleased to receive on their birthday or any special occasion. And this week you'll find 10 to 60% savings on all toys in stock, including the shipment of new ones. If your children's birthdays have passed, you might consider getting a jump on Christmas maybe, and at these great savings you can afford to do just that. The San Juan Pharmacy has great gift items for everyone in the family, so stop in today. You know, the marinas at Lake Powell are busy almost year-round. Boating, fishing, and tourism are at an all-time high down there. If you want to train for a job at a marina location on Lake Powell, check this out. October 6th.
You know, this isn't like the Army. The Army travels on a stomach. These guys travel on their knees. Athletes, the knees are
important.
Fourth down, the handoff right at the middle. Good for a first down.
McCourt, straight ahead on a second effort. Picked up about 4 yards and a first down.
Seth McCourt, we haven't heard much from him lately as Emory's been taking into the air quite a bit. But he picks up the first down.
He was actually leading ball carrier the first half. 39 yards on the ground.
37 seconds left here in the third period. Once again, San Juan 16, the Emory Spartans nothing. But Emory has a first down at the 39-yard line. Backs are in the eye, receivers wide, right and left. Here's Van Wagner in motion. Stilson, the quarterback, drops straight back, looking to the far side, bounces in front of his intended receiver, and Van Wagner.
He just threw that ball short. He had him open on a little sidelines cut and threw it 5 yards out, 5 yards behind him. No chance to even get to that.
So the clock stops with 25 seconds left in the third period. Right now, like to make a couple of comments while we've got this moment. Of course, we plan on picking up our BYU coverage and the Dallas Cowboys shortly. We'll get into that in a moment, but hang on.
They play football with Dallas.
It's second down and 10. There's Pugmire in motion to the far side. Stilson twirls. There's the handoff right up the middle. He'll get 7 yards.
7 yards. He came right up the middle on a little misdirection. Play looked like it was going wide, and the tailback coming back in behind a trap block picked up about 7 yards.
They're at the 45-yard line. Next weekend, we might mention that the BYU Cougars begin their fifth year, I believe it is, of broadcast coverage here on UTA. There's the end of the third quarter action in just a moment. Once again, it's the San Juan Broncos. Handoff once again right up the middle. Good for a first down. He's across the 50. He struggles down to the 45.
Let's see, sophomore coming in for San Juan. Number 52, Kurt Brown.
Derek Wallace comes out.
6'3", 180-pound sophomore.
At the 45-yard line, Pugmire in motion. There's the pitch.
And there's a hole, but the official didn't see it. There was a little holding going on out there, Cutmire on that block. Gain of
about 7 down to the 38.
Cutmire on that crackback, we talked about that one at halftime. It was close to being an illegal block, but the thing he did is he stuck his arm out and held him. No call. So I guess he didn't do it.
Second and long, 3 to go. Van Wagner to the near side. And the receiver wide to the right. There's Van Wagner in motion. Backs are split behind Stilson. There's the handoff.
McCourt.
McCourt breaks out one. Oh, good yardage.
McCourt was jammed up in the backfield by Glenn Gammon. Also in there, number 22, Billy Slavens, but nobody wrapped him up.
I bet someone's up lying on their face watching that one happen.
And I think they're going to bring it back and say it was called dead. There's a flag on the coaches for the officials blew it dead back there on the initial pop, I think, and the coaches came out and expressed their views on that and drew
can't
another
do that.
Flag. That's going to make it second in about a week and a half to get that far. Jason Tate in the game, Chris Singer in the game. I think we're going to see a prevent defense. Here's another flag.
And we have another flag.
We're going to send them back. We might penalize them all the way back to Emery County if they keep this up.
They're discussing who said what. We'll throw another flag. And
here comes a little bit of everybody in now.
Well, we have to remember the Broncos were looking at about a 40-yard penalty at one point.
I really think this one might put that 40-yard penalty to the Broncos to shame. I think this one might be halfway to Monticello at least.
But they're heading south.
I know, but they're going to have to go
to Monticello to get it back. You're right.
They're going to have to go north to get there.
We might mention, of course, the next week's game, we'll see the San Juan Broncos once again, but we're covering it from the point of view, I guess you'd say, of the Monticello home opener. For once, they're starting things out early with the Monticello-San Juan game this year in Monticello.
We're covering it from the point of being two local high school teams.
That's true.
I have a lot of friends on both teams. Quarterback from Monticello, Ricky Eldridge, was a member of a certain level group of athletes this summer that went to South Dakota. He's quite a fine young man. He's a senior. We've seen Ricky, Lane, Calvin Musselman, Kevin Day. We've seen that whole group now for a couple of years, for 3 years. We've seen them mature into seniors now. They started off, if you recall, a trip we made to Duchesne to see a bunch of little sophomores play a Duchesne team.
We'll be going back to Duchesne. 10 across the 50. Back in Emery territory.
45.
Stop at the 43-yard line. Not as bad as that 40-yard penalty, but still deep. They're back in their own territory looking at about 27 yards for a first down.
I don't know if they're through. Maybe they are. Okay, unsportsmanlike conduct.
That's where they set the ball.
Flags are flying. All those flags are flying, and we only got one 15-yard penalty. Third down and about 22. 23, not near as bad as we thought.
Chenoweth, the receiver to the near side now in the game. Backs are split behind Devin Stilson. There's a handoff right up the middle. He'll get back a good part of that 17-yard penalty.
He got back about 7-8 yards of that.
Number 42, the ball carrier.
McCourt. Seth McCourt.
You know what they're doing, basically. Here comes Jason limping off again. He's having trouble with that left knee, I believe. We'd have to go. Here comes Glenn Gammon in. Glenn's going to play a little defensive end now. Glenn's on the outside. Well, they were looking for a punt. They're not getting it. Glenn's going to rush. This is the prevent defense. Glenn Gammon's gone in on the end. He and Jimmy Swenson, defensive ends. Jason Watkins at nose guard there. The only ones going
here's
in.
A step.
They're looking
straight
for the
back.
Screen. They're throwing deep now. Jason Watkins that time. Get a little discussive on what we were talking about as far as the screen. Stood right up the middle of them. Jimmy Swenson came in, got a real good hit on the quarterback. He threw the ball away. Should be, we're looking at this right. San Juan should have it first and 10 from the right 47-yard line.
They'll bring up a first and 10 for the Broncos, heading the other direction.
San Juan needs to get a good offensive drive this time to get this thing going. Get some confidence going with their offense. This is a pretty fair Emery County team, but I think the Broncos are a little further along right now than Emery County is.
10:08 left in the fourth period. 16-0. They're at least that far ahead. The Broncos now have the ball just to this side of the 50-yard line from the 48. Two receivers to the near side. Backs in the eye behind Jens Nielsen. There's the snap. There's the pitch. Slavin's the ball carrier to the near side. He's down to the 45, the 40. Knocked out of bounds at the 37.
Slavin's looks like he's got first down yardage. He picked up 12 yards on that run.
They'll say he stepped out at the 40-yard line, but still excellent yardage, Danny.
Billy Slavin's running hard, came out, and sold us a pretty good stiff arm there on a couple of the Emory County defensive backs, cornerback defensive back, kept those feet going. Billy's a tough runner, shall we?
It took a total of 8 seconds, so we've got 10 exact minutes left to go, 16-0. The Broncos once again trying to move downfield.
I was surprised there wasn't a flag thrown on that last play. David Lee moved a little. Quick handoff to Billy again. He's gone for
5 yards.
Five more. We discussed this before the game, you and I did. I told you, I thought Billy was going to be a workhorse tonight. We're going to see Billy a lot this year. Not a lot of speed, just tremendous drive and aggressiveness and strength.
So at the 35-yard line, clock is rolling. Second down and 5.
I think one reason we might be seeing him so much is Jason's fragile knees. Jason's got that bad knee.
Segarin lead to the near side, backs in the eye. There's the handoff to the first, the fullback, and he stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a yard loss.
And Craig ran into big number 79. That's that Halliday going. And 262 pounds. If he gets his hands on Craig Black, he's going to win every time.
That will bring up third down and
down about six.
Six
okay.
Or seven.
We'll go 6-10. 16-0, we can compromise on that. Chris Singer splitting out wide to the right.
Baxter split behind Nielsen, 3rd and 6. Slavin's in black behind Nielsen. He rolls to his right, looking downfield. There's a flag. He's got Singer, but out of his reach, but the flag is down.
We're going to have a holding call, I think, where that one came from. Looked like one of the Bronco linemen had a little holding going on.
It is a holding call against San Juan.
Holding against the Broncos.
That will bring up third and long yardage. While they mark this one off, now we can get our comment in. Of course, next weekend, the BYU Cougars begin their fourth or fifth season of coverage here on KUTA, and their first game will be against an in-state rival, against Utah State.
Yeah, that's
not too much of a rival, but still a rival.
I have to ask you, do you know Don Gammon, the tackle for the Broncos? Do you know Don?
I know his cousin, Glenn, very well.
You should get to know Donald. Very, I guess, adamant about the Cowboys.
You'd be surprised. There are
State.
A lot of Cowboy fans.
We've been trying to talk to him about that problem of being adamant about the Cowboys.
The Broncos have the ball. Nielsen straight back on the third long. There's a screen pass to Singer. It bounces in front of him. That will bring up fourth down. I was surprised to find that a lot of the people that have moved to Blanding from Wyoming, many of my friends from Wyoming are big Cowboy fans. And so that's why we decided to go ahead and cover them this year. Not much of a team.
Okay, I'll let that one slide. My friends from Wyoming know why I said that.
Tomorrow night, or tonight if you're listening Saturday morning, it will be the Dallas Cowboys and the Houston Oilers. Danny and I have heard this story many years. There's something called the Governor's Cup. We'll talk about it in a moment. Singer back for the punt. There's a snap. There's the kick. A good high kick, Danny.
Off the side of his foot. Off the side of his foot and out of bounds. They're going to have to spot that one. He got it inside of him.
So Emory goes back on offense. Broncos holding penalty stopped them cold. They still lead 16-0 with 8:20 to go.
Broncos, be honest with you, what we're going to see the rest of this ball game, we're going to see Stilson, who I think is getting a little bit gun shy. He's been pounded pretty good in this ball game by the Broncos. He's going to be rearing back throwing the ball.
Receivers wide right and left. Devin Stilson, the quarterback. If he's true to form, he'll drop straight back. There's a quick pass.
Quick pass over the left.
Trapped, I believe, yes.
No good. No good. Trapped that ball. Threw that ball. Well, we had him open. Had him open there for an instant, but threw it too low. Trapped it on the ground.
Stilson, the intended receiver.
Second down and 10.
I'm curious if we're looking at twins or whatever.
I've got him 6 for 18 now. I don't think so. I think young Mr. Stilson.
Younger brother.
Is a cousin. Junior.
Devin Stilson, the quarterback. Pugmire to the near side. Another receiver to the far side. Once again, he drops back a quick pass, same direction. And it's trapped again.
That's Pugmire. Pugmire that time running a little hitch, coming inside, just stopping, trying to get that pass where he's got a little room to operate with all that speed. But Stilson again throwing the ball on the ground.
Make it our elevation here shortly, hopefully.
Well, you know, the thing I'm seeing over there, I think they're trying to lull our quarterback to sleep with those little hitches. I think we're going to see him hitch and go here in a minute on that right side. And he's got the man out there now that can do it. Number 34.
Van Wagner to the far side, as you mentioned. Dell Stilson to the near side.
Just Nielsen cheating over a little on defense, going to take that inside away.
Straight
there's
back.
A little square out there.
He's in trouble. He's down.
He's in trouble, and there's a late hit on number 51. They're going to call a late hit on Jason Watkins. Eric Laws with the sack, but they're going to call a late hit.
Drop back inside the 10. That's where the flag went down.
Here it comes. Personal foul. They haven't signaled, but I can see this one coming. I'm not sure what that sign was, but I know what the penalty was. We can all see exactly what happened. Third down now. This is going to be fourth down. They flipped the marker over. Fourth down. It was after the play. So
we got
fourth, fourth and about
fourth and six. From the 25.
Couple of the Emory County Spartans in. We're running low on time, 8:01. I think we're going to see them probably go for this one. Yes, they're going to go for it. 8:01, a little early though. You know, two touchdowns and two 2-point conversions. We've got to tie a game, I believe.
Shinoweth to the near side. Is that Pugmire to the far side? Backs are in the eye. Quarterback drops straight back. He's once Shinoweth, but it's
complete.
Greg too
Blacker.
Low.
Greg Blacker right on top of the play. That time. Shinoweth came out, didn't really get first down yardage on that. San Juan's going to take over on their own 25-yard line, first and 10. Broncos put this one in. We can all sit up and breathe easier. A two-touchdown lead worries me, worries everyone here. You got to feel good about being in the lead, but that's not enough.
So on the incomplete pass, we turned the ball over, fourth down. That play, and now it's first and 10 for the Broncos.
A little grinded out offense right here. I just have to believe. Greg Black in the backfield. Billy Slavin's tailback.
In the eye behind Jens Nielsen. There's the handoff to Slavin's through a hole on the left side. He'll get 5-6 yards.
Tackle,
oh boy,
a
fumble. David Lee Speed will maybe save this one. Yeah, brings him down at the
50. Here's a flag coming.
Move the sticks. Emery L. And go back on offense.
So we're looking now, the team from Emory County now is looking first down inside the San Juan 40, so 7:40 to go. We still got a lot of time.
From the 36, Nielsen drops straight back under pressure. He'll be dropped. Oh, no, he gets out of that problem.
Pressure back there. He's able to get the ball off.
He threw that ball away, but he got Jimmy Swenson got in there and got his hands on him. Nielsen somehow got out of it. Threw the ball away just to save the down. We're looking at second and 10 now. Jason Tate's going to be limping off the field. Here he comes. That knee is bothering him now. We, you know, to be honest with you, Coach Duber and I talked about it. We figured fourth quarter we were going to see this, that knee beginning to bother him. Jason, I think rather than going to the dance tonight, might be sitting in the tub downstairs with a lot of ice on that leg.
Pugmire to the near side. Stilson to the far side. Baxter split. There's Pugmire in motion. Devin Stilson, the quarterback. There's a
clip.
Pitch.
There is a clip on that cutback. He's met by Jens Nielsen, but
the pitch to McCourt. He doesn't get much, maybe a couple.
He's they're running that. That's an illegal block they're doing with that wide receiver. He's coming in and then cutting our guy right in the back, and then he's down the court. Which is called kosher, I don't think. If he let him turn and then do it, that's one thing, but he's coming in on it before he gets turned.
And that will bring up third down and about seven. Receivers wide right and left. Backs are in the eye. Here's the snap. Drops straight back. Looking for his own. Knocked
Jimmy
down.
Jimmy Ray, good job. Jimmy Ray that time. So in for Jason Tate at that defensive end. Came across. Got his hands up in the air. Batted that pass down. Good play by the sophomore. He's back at the surface. He's having to play. Due to the injury with Jason, he's having to play. Did a good job. Fourth and seven.
Fourth and seven. Pugmire comes in. Dell Stilson come in. Stilson to the far side. Pugmire to the near side. It's almost not important to say the backs are in the eye behind Devin Stilson, the quarterback. Here's the snap. He looks for a quick pass, a lateral.
Double pass.
There's the option pass. Oh, he dropped it.
Had his tight end coming across the middle that time. Hit him in a bad spot.
Mortensen right dropped it at the 20.
Hit him right in the hands. It's not a good spot to hit a receiver, I don't guess. That's going to turn it over to Broncos. 6:42 to go. Sam Juan needs to hang on to the football now. Need to hang on to the football.
.642 left in the fourth quarter, 16-0. Sam Juan takes over.
Broncos defense looking good. They've shut them out. The offense needs to get something going here. They need to get a sustained drive going, something to get the confidence in this offense.
Nielsen, the quarterback. There's a fumble. Emery Spartans have it.
Emery County has it again.
Start out as sort of an option play.
Well, it was a misdirection. It was a misdirection play when the quarterback came around. Somehow they missed connection on the misconnected with the handoff.
All of a sudden the ball was sitting on the ground and Emery was on top of it. So, once again, another turnover. Have you, what's our turnover count now? Have you quit counting those?
I count after about 10.
Back on offense, Devin Stilson, the quarterback, number 7. Receivers wide right and left. There's a hand. Oh, no, a reverse. Pugmire, he's around the far side. He'll get some good. Oh.
He's going to be in trouble right there. David Lee stood him up right there. He picked up about 7 yards. But David Lee stood him up, and a couple of the Broncos came in flying low. Link Diamond. Six in on that time.
About 6 yards on the carry. On the reverse, second down and 4.
See, I got 14 turnovers so far.
Stilson, the quarterback. He'll throw. There's a pass out of the backfield. Dropped at the 20.
And we've got another cramp over here, I do believe.
Seth McCourt, the receiver out of the backfield. He's dropped to the 20, and you're right, David Lee comes off the field.
David Lee came up, made a good cut tackle on him, knocked his feet out from under him. In the process, must have got kicked or something to cause a cramp. 5:30 to go. Fourth period action, 16-0. San Juan Broncos on top. Emery threatening over there.
We're going to be first down with 5:30 left in the fourth period.
Third and real short.
Backs are split. Devin Stilson, the quarterback. You may see our token handoff. There it is. Good for a first down. Up to the inside the 20. Seth McCourt.
McCourt is a workhorse.
Brought down by Harrison Watkins of the Broncos.
Was Van Gogh.
Van Buren.
Straight down play.
Backs are in the eye, receivers wide, right, and left. We'll probably go back to our passing game. Now, there's a whistle before we get anything off.
I wonder if we've got a delay.
Here comes the flag.
Motion. Someone must have lined up offsides.
Emery picks up another 5 with the penalty.
Second and 5. First and 5.
This is the closest to the Bronco goal line I say they've got in this game.
15-yard line. First and 5.
Just at the 15-yard line, Devin Stilson, the quarterback. And one man in motion, Pugmire, looking downfield. There's a pass. It's complete. He's close. There's a touchdown. Emery Spartans put some points on the board with 5:04 left. The pass out of the backfield to
number 85, Kelly Mortensen, 15 yards.
So to the tight end. Six points, 16-6. I was kind of hoping for a shutout, but
they've got to go for two. They have to go for two. That was a little bit of a sucker play, really. They ran the Budmire Speed Demon on a slant across the middle and snuck the tight end out behind him.
Barton will attempt a two-pointer.
Two-point attempt. Baxter split behind Stilson. Receiver split wide to the right. Very wide to the left.
Broncos out in front.
There's a fake, there's a pass, that's complete.
It's good.
For the two.
Good pursuit into the end zone. Right back over there to Kelly Morrison.
Ready for the kick after Emery's first score of the game.
Emery finally gets on
back
the
back deep, Jones, Greg Black, or Singer.
52. Wade Dukes needs the ball up.
Here's the whistle. Set.
Singer and Jones.
Have one of the few kickoffs from the Emory Spartans.
We might look for onsides here. Something cute on this kickoff.
There you go. There's the onside. Over one Bronco. Boy, they better grab that ball. Emory may have it.
I think
they do. They do.
That ball went right through two of the Broncos. Nobody really put a hand on the ball. And I think we'll see a different kickoff receiving team next week. Onside kick recovered by the Spartans. 4:59 to go. Lots of time.
At the 41-yard line, the Emory Spartans recover the onside kick. I was brushing up on my football today and reading a book that I have and discussed the perfect onside kick, and that was almost the description right there.
Well, you want to. Actually, perfect onside kick. You want to do it the same way he did, but he kicked it too far.
Yes.
You wanted to land 10 yards out with a reverse spin on it and come back. But that was as effective as you could get.
Right up the middle, the handoff down to the 35, 36-yard line.
Tackled by Jason Watkins about 5 yards.
Seth McCourt, the ball carrier, back in the game.
Here come the receivers in the game. Chinworth and Pugmire.
Second and 5. Pugmire to the near side, Chinworth to the far side. Baxter split. There's the handoff right up the middle. He's struggling. He'll get maybe 2 or 3.
Jason Watkins got a hand on him early, slowed him down, allowed the rest of the Broncos to come in and stack it up. He did pick up about 3 on that one. 359, 358 count.
Once again, McCourt, the ball carrier. Picks up a couple of more. That brings up third. And a short 3. With 3:43 left, the clock rolling. 16-8, the score. San Juan on top, but the Emory Spartans have the ball on offense. Another handoff. This one spelled out, as you say, right away.
Stop cold. Jason Watkins, Glenn Guyman, both of them in on that spot.
So a critical fourth down possibly for the Spartans with 3:21 and the clock rolling. They have to keep this drive alive, although with turnovers the way they've been.
14 so far.
We won't bet. bet on anything. Well, would you call an onside kick that they recovered another turnover?
I would almost. Here comes that crackback block again. That's illegal motion, and they flagged it. They flagged it that time. They got it. Broncos stopped him short, but that penalty's on that Tugmeyer on that motion trying to get in there and crack back. And
he
turned too quick. It's going to be. And there's a Bronco down. Let's see who's down.
I think he's up now.
Wouldn't surprise me if it wasn't Jimmy Swenson, and it is Jimmy Swenson. That crackback block is a very dangerous block. That's how a lot of high school ball players get hurt. A lot of ball players didn't. Because they never see the guy coming. He hits him from the side. You're just not made to bend that away. Buckmeyer, though, took it in motion early. Broncos declined the penalty.
Take the ball
instead with 2:53 to go. Now we really need to find some stickle.
At the 32-33-yard line, it's first and 10 for the San Juan Broncos with 2:53 on the clock, 16-8 the score.
You don't like he'd throw the ball here, do you? That would be surprising to every county.
Three backs lined up behind Jens Nielsen. There's the handoff.
Billy Slavin
spins away from one, gets maybe four.
And did you notice when Billy popped through that hole that time, he had both hands wrapped around the football. Our score, 223-222 and counting.
They're at the 36-yard line. Second and six. Everyone's in tight. Back split behind Jens Nielsen. Quarterback the whole game, with the exception of two plays. There's the handoff. They will go nowhere. In fact, I would say he lost one on that play.
Tell you the job Billy's done tonight. That's 17 carries already.
Staff out here on the field and Glenn Guyman and Billy Slavens. That's all of Saturday right there. We can only cross our fingers that they'll be at work tomorrow. But a good show tonight. Hand off once again there. And Jones this time coming to the near side.
He's staying in bounds. He's going to keep that clock going. 122, 121. We're looking at fourth down. Aaron Jones for about 3 yards, and we got a timeout called quickly by the Emery County Sparkers.
While we've got that timeout, you won't be in.
Now, Jim Langston might be the most important player on the field. He's got to get a good snap.
One deep back to receive. There, a very short punt. Danny will come down at about the 47-48 yard line, I'm asking.
He's going to give him a little bit. He's going to give him a full house defense right now. He's going to loosen the linebackers, though.
Devin Stilson, the quarterback for Emory, at the 48-yard line of the Broncos. Straight back, quick pass. Oh, incomplete.
Lost 4 seconds on that.
Van Wagner, the intended receiver, at the 44.
Someone just threw off the kick tee from the kickoff for the Emory County Spartans.
Receivers wide right and left. Second and 10 with the incompletion. There's Stilson. Straight back, looking downfield, dancing around. There's the pass. Off the hands.
And there's an out-of-bounds call on Craig Black. Had his hands in his back just before the ball got there. Took another 7 seconds, but we got interference at the Bronco 25-yard line. Ball was over the man's head. Shouldn't have been a flag on that one. That ball wasn't catchable. Ball was not catchable, but they're going to call the flag, I think.
Not a popular call on this side of the field, if you can hear the fans out front.
Not really. Coach Hoover discussed it with the official, but you don't change the officials. No, they're bringing it back. They're going to bring it back. That ball wasn't catchable. Had to be the call. They're allowed to do that. No, let's see. What is it? They're going to call a penalty. Okay. It's not from the spot of the foul now. It's going to be a stepped-off penalty.
They'll pick up a first down on the 15-yard penalty.
And only lost 7 seconds. Interference on Craig Black.
It's almost as good as the pass right there.
Yes. Stops the clock.
So with exactly 1 minute to go, the Emory Spartans move into San Juan territory, deeper into their territory at the 34-yard line with first and 10 on the strength of that penalty. Van Wagner to the near side. Stilson rolls to his right, looking downfield. There's a receiver. It's caught. He breaks one tackle. He'll be brought down near another first down.
Clock's still rolling. They don't have, I think they've only got one timeout left. They're going to take a timeout right here, and that's going to leave them with one. I think San Juan going to huddle up on defense, discuss it. When we come back from this timeout, Shelby, they're going to have the ball right about the 25, 26-yard line. It's going to be close.
Well, we've got this timeout. We'll take a break for station identification. You're listening to the High School Game of the Week here on KUTA. Once again, 50 seconds left to go after that Emory timeout. They're facing a second down and about three. Straight back, Stilson, there's the pass over the official's head, but out of the Pugmire, 3-2.
Intended for number one, Dale Pugmire.
Third down and a little over two, maybe 3 yards to go. 16-8, the score. 46 seconds left.
3-3. It's been an interesting call. Do they use their last timeout? Do they run this ball and then use their last timeout?
Receivers wide, right and left. One comes in motion. Van Wagner to the near side.
Straight drop back. There's
the
sidelines.
Oh, out of
the flag. Oh, he pulled his flag out, but he didn't throw it. He pulled it out. He had his hand on it, and Lee was pulling on it, but he didn't throw it. Jimmy Swenson over there with his arm around Craig saying, whoa, buddy, whoa. Close, but not close enough. 4th and 3 now. 41 seconds left.
Do or die, possibly, for the Emory Spartans, trailing by 8, 4th and 3, 41 seconds. Stilson, the quarterback. There's the snap, a quick rush, but a quick handoff, too, right up the middle.
He was jammed pretty good. I think he got the first down, though. That being the case, there's 35. They're going to call official timeout to measure.
Number 51.
Jason Watkins, Cobb on the stop that time. First down.
While they measure, we will.
Well, they're not going to measure.
Oh, no, they didn't.
They're going to start the clock right here. The clock should start 33-32. They're out of timeouts. I think they're going to have to throw this one out of bounds and talk about it. San Juan now backed up, loosening the defense up a little.
Backs in the eye, receivers wide right and left. Stilson to throw. There's the pass. It's complete. He's out of bounds at the 12-yard line.
17 seconds to go.
That's Dell Stilson, the receiver, from Devin Stilson, the quarterback. And they stopped the clock with 17 seconds.
Gained about 7 or 8 yards. That time they were playing back a little, maybe a little too cautious.
Stepped out at about the 13 and a half yard line.
Of course, David Lee's playing that free safety. He's the last one between there and the goal line. 17
seconds left. Now they will bring the sticks in for a measurement.
17 seconds and just about, second down, it really doesn't matter.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's not really a critical measurement, but they still will have just a couple of plays to work with at best. While they do that, they have to bring the sticks across the field. Once again, we'll try and run through this all at once without any interruptions, hopefully. The BYU Cougars begin their season against Utah State on Saturday, September the 6th. The Dallas Cowboys begin their season on the 6th.
Second down, about a foot, which is immaterial. They've got 17 seconds to go, about 14 yards for a touchdown. Then they've got to have a two-point conversion to tie. I don't, to be honest with you, I don't even like the thought of a tie, you know?
Second and about a foot. Spartan
backs are in the eye, four, receivers split wide to the right and left. Just still straight back, back. There's the pass, so the way right downfield, looking for the goal line.
Had a nice defensive, no, they're calling touchdown. T. tipped up in the air and caught laying on his back. Touchdown. There's a flag on the play.
The scoreboard has not changed yet, but it is 16-14. They gave him the touchdown. Chenna with the ball carrier. Here's a pass into the end zone. Complete for the two-point conversion. There's a pass out to David Lee. He's got it with 5 seconds left. The clock will expire. It's out. He's down the sidelines. He's knocked out at the 31-yard line. That's the game, Danny.
That's time ran out.
I think we're doing something very interesting here, and maybe you can help us explain it. It's a sudden death situation. Dennis Nielsen, the quarterback, takes the snap. Everything falls apart, and he's dropped for a loss. Now you explain why.
Okay, put somebody on the spot here. This is a format they use in high school football on occasions to decide tie ball games, but they only use the playoffs. Maybe it's something they're doing. You know, I must apologize. I didn't go to the Bills meeting this year. What they do is they put the ball on the 10, and they give a team a series of plays to drive it in, then they give it to the other team. And, you know, I'm at a loss. Beats me.
Well, with a loss on the play, there's a pitch.
Aaron Jones.
Aaron Jones got it. He's headed around the near side. He'll be dropped inside the 10, about the 9.
Aaron Jones came back. What, we lost plus a couple. Get four downs apiece to try and get the ball in the end zone.
The ball's at the 9. They've had two downs so far. This will be third down and I guess goal to go. Third and 9. We'll set it up. Regular offense. Everyone's in tight. Nielsen, the quarterback. Backs are split. Here's the snap. He drops straight back looking downfield. He wants to throw. He's there's a fumble.
Jukes in there that time. Wade Jukes got in, knocked the ball out of his hands. Jens recovered it. We're looking at fourth down now. And we've got a timeout. No, we don't have a timeout.
I hope they don't give timeout. It will be fourth down from the 11. And if as our guess is correct, they don't do anything, we'll... Whether they do anything or not, they'll march down to the other end of the field. Maybe they'll just flip around here. It might be nice. We can have a good view of the Emory Spartans attempt.
Possible fourth down. We've got a second down listed on the scoreboard, but I think it's fourth.
The scoreboard's not operating right now. 16-16, the score, of course, as we're in this special overtime. Jens drops straight back. He wants to throw. There's
there he
the receiver
is.
Way out there.
Oh,
touchdown.
He's going in. There's a touchdown, and let's see.
So the extra point attempt, no good. Of it.
Down there a little bit now.
Backs are split. Stilson, the quarterback. There's the handoff. He'll be stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Stopped by the line of Glenn Guyman in there. Our Saturday man. He's going to be playing the state tomorrow. Getting a little news in, right after. Made an excellent play that time. Second down. About 8-9 yards to go. They're going for the goal line.
Essentially, yeah. Essentially second and goal. No matter where they're at. Stilson, the quarterback, he's got backs in the eye, receivers wide, right and left. Here's one in motion. He wants to throw. Here's the pass. It's incomplete.
They've seen that one three times. They came up and made a good play on it. Shelby, I got a question to ask you. Do radio announcers get overtime for extra periods?
No, but you know it's 10:30.
I know where my kids are.
I know this will be tape delayed, but for us to be here at 10:30 in the evening for a high school football game is very rare.
I know where my kids are, two of them are at home, and one of them's out there rooting for the Broncos in a Bronco uniform. So. Third down and goal. I guess if they don't make it, we win, I hope.
They'll have two more downs to go, third down. Stilson wants to throw, he's rolling left, looking downfield, there's a pass, it's... Oh, he dropped it!
He had it, he was wide open, all he had in front of him was two blades of grass, and if he caught the ball, it was a touchdown, he couldn't hang on to it. Let's see what we got. We got officials waving all over, but there's one waving his hands. We got a timeout call by the team from Emory County. I don't know, you know. I guess this is some sort of a playoff format due to this being a league game for the Broncos. However, it's not a league game for Emory County. They're in the northern region. San Juan being an independent, though, this game counts as a region game for their region record. So that must have something to do with why we're having this playoff format.
Where did we get this from? Where did this information come from?
Four down a piece.
Oh, weird. Danny now will have one more try.
Well, that's about all they needed. Last time, with closing, 9 seconds to go, they needed one more try.
And they got
punched it in and tied it up. Let's see what they do here. We're going to have to look for some awfully good defense by the Broncos.
Our score, in theory, is 22-16. Emery's got one play to get a touchdown. There's a quick pass.
There's another pass coming up.
And he's got that for a touchdown.
And there's the old screen, the old
extra point. There's a flag.
Let's see what this is. I gotta get a rule governing something,
really. There's a snap. It's down. Juke says, oh, it's a fake.
They're not going for it.
There's a pass into the end zone. Complete for two.
Point. There's a lineman downfield. Is there a call anywhere?
Yeah! Yeah! 20, Jason Byrne. Ball goes to Dearden, number 10. Thank you. into the back.
Thank you. Yeah. Pass going along again to number one, And up goes Phillips, number 21, he moves down over the 20 to about the 22-yard line.
Problems or somebody goes and moves those kids down there.
Thank you.
Robinson pushes off to Phillips. Phillips is back behind the line for a loss of six.
Thank you. Number 25, Run it again, Paul. They're down, there's going to be more.